visual aid to enhance audience understanding. Finally, effectively use at least one visual aid to enhance the understanding, audience understanding. Time allotted is 5 to 7 minutes. All the best to us, Master.
Thank you.
Big round of applause, please.
Let me start this meeting by asking you a question. Here is the question. What is one thing to make you live longer, reduce your chances of dying from heart disease or stroke, improve your memory, happiness, and productivity? One thing.
Amber.
Exercise.
Somebody said exercise. And nice that you said amber. Well, let me briefly mention that exercise, if you do regularly, it will be doing helping you to achieve all those things I mentioned and much more. That's the crux of my topic today. For those, and thanks Dr. Sunita introducing me, I'm a doctor, mental health professional. I was not a very physical person until the very tragic incident. I found some of my close mates having a serious medical condition that would have been prevented by exercise. I studied exercise, its physiology, pathophysiology, and then I came to know something interesting. It's not the physical exercise, the physical results we're talking about. Tremendous amount of research has been done on the mental aspects of exercise. That's the crux of my presentation today. As a doctor, my duty to warn you, and this is a warning, that exercise, if we do, has been known to cause health and happiness. So you are responsible. Well, here are the points I'll be discussing in brief. Let's talk about stress to start with. Stress and depression has been studied extensively. In fact, there is almost conclusive evidence of efficacy of exercise in benefiting stress and depression. In the age when you are living in depression everywhere, WHO mentions that 2020, major depression with a major cause of disability worldwide. This has a place. Exercise is something which can help alleviate that. The major thing we talk about exercise, again, how it works, the so-called happiness chemicals. You might have heard about dopamine and serotonin. That's the mechanism. But forgetting about that, what is important, exercise works to relieve your stress. Second point, it's increased productivity and cognitive decline. I don't know if you know it or not, we are living in an era with an epidemic proportional increase in dementia and other cognitive dysfunctions. Exercise has been shown to be very effective in, if not preventing, in reducing the impact of dementia and delaying its onset, because it's going to happen anyway, especially if you're living beyond 80. Sharpen memory and boost brain power. This has been another very effective result of exercise. Any form of exercise, we'll be discussing a little bit about that, will be improving your memory, your brain power. It has been studied in a very nice study in which in a school, they brought forward the PE, the physical education class, from the latter part of the day, beginning part of the day. They found a discernible increase in the SAT score in children. Has been publicized as one of the very important news eulogizing the effectiveness of exercise. As a result, maybe as a byproduct of it, self-confidence, especially if you are happy and you are doing well, your self-confidence is increased. That is, that happens. And also, it gives you the capacity to enjoy outside. Because we have been made with us to relax ourselves. Sometimes we are too anxious to use it. Exercise takes a barrier that many people don't realize. And if nothing else impresses you, at least going out, outdoors, will at least elevate your mood. Next slide. There's a common myth that exercise is only applicable for, or it's not applicable for elderly or for young children, but nothing could be far from truth. Lots of exercise have been proposed, prescribed for younger people, and as well as older people. It's, I have already discussed its role in improving memory power, minimizing health risks, we have discussed at length. Especially we are talking about the boost energy and that effectiveness among elderly people, which is something which is crippling old age. And exercise stands as a possible non-pharmacological alternative to address that issue. Children. Well, I have two children myself. I call them GG1, GG2, the twins. Gadget Girl 1, Gadget Girl 2. They're always with gadgets. Anyway, so that's the only way to recognize twins. And unfortunately, they don't exercise. And we have seen their grade plummeting. And this is so easy and this polished, too easy to believe that regular physical exercise would be benefiting their memory, their school grades. There is a popular myth that exercise has to be very strenuous. But all that has been known till now, research has almost conclusively proven 30 minutes a day probably good enough. You might think, well, less than 30 minutes? Yes. At least 10 minutes in a go and 3 spots, 30 minutes probably would be adequate. And that would be giving you almost all benefits that you can get from the if you do it at a time. If you do more, it's better than this. Group role is a good idea. So the group factors like that might help you to get benefits from others. Others are exercising and you do benefit with that. Space then it will help is an issue, but that is not the case. Even in one place, standing that lady is doing, it's called jogging in space. You can do it in one place, you don't have to go anywhere. But probably it's a good idea to be outside nature and you get plenty of vitamin D and other aspects. So what I'm going to tell is that exercise is here to stay. And we are familiar with its physical benefits, but sometimes we know the mental benefits of exercise, which is easy to get, and only thing you have to do is to make a determination. And probably we should end my talk with this quote. You're only one workout are you from good mood. And that's it. Over to you.